5-year mission to confront feminists, to call out SJWs, to boldly go where no man has gone before. I'm Robert Brockway, the president of the Australian Men's Rights Association. The entire crew, consisting of Tom Golden, Mike Buchanan, and Yelizaveta Chikov, is here today, but we're not within queer feminists. We occasionally meet up on this starship to carry out the important work of the Patriarchy Council. But today we're here to make an exciting announcement. I was stoked to be hosting the 6th International Conference on Men's Issues in Sydney, Australia this year. I spat the dummy when I had to cancel it due to COVID-19. The conference had carved it. Struth, I said, what are we going to do? Mike Buchanan called me and said, she'll be right. Well, he didn't actually say that because he's a pommy bastard. But he did suggest we make this year's conference virtual. I said, bonza. We'll publish pre-recorded videos on the hour every hour for 5 days, concluding on International Men's Day, November the 19th. That's 120 videos in total, starting at midday on Saturday, November the 14th, and ending at midday on International Men's Day, Sydney time. We'll have lots of great speakers from the men's rights movement, but we're going to take advantage of the next conference being virtual to consider video proposals from anyone supportive of men's rights and men's issues. This conference is going to go off. Well, I'm as dry as a dead dingo's donga. I need to see a man about a snake. I'm off to the Botlo to give me some Chateau Neuilly Sol Wagga Wagga. Agent Golden, over to you, mate.
Thank you, sir. I'm Tom Golden. I'm from menaregood.com, and I'm coming to you today from the deck of the Starship Minterprise. Yes, the Starship Minterprise, a place where men are respected and admired. You know, the culture here is one of admiration and respect for men. We think men are good. What a concept. You know, if you're less than 40 years old, maybe even less than 50, you've never experienced a time where your culture has thought that men are good. You've always lived in a culture that thought that men were toxic or there's something wrong with men. And what did that do to your upbringing? What did that do to your capacity to develop as a young man, as a man? What a mess. And you know, when we get used to this thing on the Starship Enterprise of thinking men are good, and we do go down to Earth, it's jarring. Oh! It's a shocking thing to go and hear all this stuff about how men are doing this and men are bad and men are the cause of all the problems and this complete misunderstanding of men and boys. It really is quite sad. Even after a while, you kind of get used to it. You know, you get used to this whole drone of there's something wrong with men, right? Oh boy. Doesn't have to be like that, guys. It does not have to be like that. Can you imagine a culture that you lived in that thought that men were okay the way they were? Can you imagine a culture that thought that appreciated men for what they did for the family? Appreciated men for what they did for the community? What they did for their workplace? What they did for their country? Appreciated men in general? What would that be like? And how would that change your own development, your own perception of yourself as a man, or as a young man, or as a boy? It'd be a big deal. So we hope someday you're going to get to join us on the Starship Enterprise to get a sense of what it's like to be in a community where men are thought of as being good. Men are thought of as being good. What a foreign concept for too many people. And you know, maybe instead of doing that, you can just come to ICMI 20. ICMI 20 will have the very same ideas. They hold men in high regard. They think of men as being good and being worthy. They admire and respect men for the way they are. So come to ICMI 20 and you'll get the same kind of experience. It's refreshing. Agent Hobson, on to you.
Thank you, Agent Golden. I'm Elizabeth Hobson, recently appointed leader of the political party Justice for Men and Boys and the Women Who Love Them, j4mb.org.uk, which was founded 7 years ago. You're quite right, Agent Golden. The ICMI is the antidote to the dominant gynocentric and misandrous cultural narratives that plague Earth societies today and have done for so many years. It's a sobering fact that despite our level of civilization, we still hold on to the outdated attitude of male disposability that brutalizes our societies. Men and boys are disadvantaged and demeaned in so many ways. From the cradle, when baby boys are not protected from having their genitals mutilated, through their childhoods, when girls receive favorable treatment in schools and developing minds are filled with toxic feminism by state-sponsored indoctrination, through adulthood, when men are disadvantaged in work, in the family, in healthcare provision, and in the criminal justice system, to the grave, when men die younger. And the societal shrug at the unnecessary suffering that is inflicted on men is our civilization's final barbarism. And as John Stuart Mill put it, we must not suppose that the barbarisms to which men cling the longest must be lesser barbarisms than those which they earlier shake off. This year's virtual ICMI will consist of a data dump like no other, bringing the best speakers delivering deeply important messages into homes all over the world to usher in the biggest International Men's Day ever. We're at a point in time when feminism and gynocentrism are losing ground, a time when the experiences of men and boys are reaching ears, a quickening of revolutionary progress. And this year, the revolution will be televised. Agent Buchanan, over to you.
Thank you, Agent Hobson. I'm Mike Buchanan, chairman and former leader of the party Agent Hobson now leads. She was previously our director of communications for the last 2 years, and I know she'll take the party to new heights, and I'll do all I can as party chairman to support her. It's a pleasure to be here on the Starship Enterprise, working on the arrangements for the 2020 International Conference on Men's Issues. It will be the sixth conference in a remarkable series, which brings together men and women from around the world with an interest in men's issues. Public understanding of those issues and the roles played by politicians, especially feminist politicians, and others in disadvantaging men and boys grows with every passing year. People are increasingly aware that one inevitable consequence of female privileging is male disadvantaging. And of course, it's mainly men who pay the bills for this social engineering. Men in the UK pay almost 3/4 of the income taxes which fund the state's many assaults on the human rights of men and boys. Men are paying state-sanctioned muggers to assault them. Men's disadvantages result not only from the actions and inactions of politicians, of course, but also people working in well-funded charities that work only for women, and people working in organizations in the criminal justice system, the family courts, education, the healthcare sector, and many other sectors. We're keen to publish videos of people with first-hand experience of that disadvantaging, to expose how the disadvantaging takes place in practice. So we're looking for whistleblowers to shine a light on how they've seen men, perhaps themselves, being disadvantaged. If you need to remain anonymous for any reason, no problem. We'll do whatever it takes to protect your identity. For example, we could pixelate your face or have another person read out the contents of a document you supply. Email me first with outline details of what you'd like to speak about. My email address is in the load bar. For this conference, we're planning to publish videos on the hour, every hour, from midday on the 14th of November, 2020, Sydney time, to midday on the 19th of November, International Men's Day. That's 120 videos in total. We already have commitments from over 60 people to provide videos, details on the conference website. We hope you'll enjoy the event. Finally, I couldn't pass up this opportunity to mention my new website, laughingatfeminists.com. Feminists are laughable, so we laugh at them. Feminists are ridiculous, so we ridicule them. Feminists are ludicrous, so we ludicrize them. Agent Brockway, do you have something to say?
Thank you, Agent Buchanan. I do. Gentlemen, you're absolutely sure we should have Elizabeth and Chico up here on board this starship. We know we can trust Agent Hobson, of course, but what do we know about Chico? I feel uneasy being trapped up here with her. No woman can be 100% of the space crime.
What was that, Agent Brockway?
Nothing, I swear. Agent Chico, do you have anything you'd like to say?
No, I'll just sit here and look pretty. Film log 1.0, recorded for the board of the Vagina Liberation Front. Did you see that? I was the last to speak, as usual. Listening to all that mansplaining has given me a headache. Surrounded by misogynists every day of the week. Take the infiltration mission, Elizaveta. It'll be easy, you said. Those dumbass men will never spot you. They'll be too busy nursing their venereal diseases. St. Clementine Ford, give me strength to survive the SS Enterprise. Why didn't the Patriarchy Council go all the way and call it the SS Patriarchal Oppression of Women? The results are just in from the latest salary survey of crews across the Patriarchy Council's fleet of starships, and there's a 3.7% gender pay gap. Outrageous. Yesterday, Agent Golden ordered me to put the bins outside. He said that's equality. Women doing dirty jobs is not equality. I do all the emotional labor on this ship, all of it. To ask me to do the physical labor too? Ugh, it's just too much. Anyway, it's come to my attention that this bunch of misogynists are hosting a virtual international conference on men's issues in November in the run-up to International Men's Day. I spit on Men's Day. As my political heroine Jess Phillips MP once said, every day is Men's Day, so every day I spit. I urge everyone not to submit videos for the conference. Otherwise, they'll be encouraging misogynists to keep oppressing women, as they have for millennia. Women are strong. Women are amazing. Women need gender quotas. Let's work together to screw the patriarchy. Over and out. End of Femlock 1.0.
To be able to talk with your mouth closed, but you need to be smiling to do it. And as a feminist, I find smiling very challenging. I wouldn't want those toxic patriarchs on the starship to think I was happy in their company. Does my bum look big in this spacesuit? These suits aren't flattering for female astronauts. They are designed by men. For men.